with travelling and talking on menstruation primarily, because I'm talking to women in such an open way, it seems that women just start to ask me other questions. I always make them feel comfortable and lead into things that we could, you know, talking about relationships and sexuality and that type of thing. And of course, the questions that come forward often just on sex itself. It's amazing how many young girls marry and they still don't understand their body. They've never had an orgasm. They don't know what an orgasm is. They think it's something just the male has. In fact, with looking at women of the world, and particularly my passion with female circumcision and female genital mutilation, with the clitoris being removed, it means that these women can't have a clitoral orgasm. One of the products I developed, which is a G-spot stimulator, actually inserts into the vagina and stimulates the G-spot. If this is a vaginal area, and this would be the stimulator, or it could be the finger or the penis, if we look at it from that angle, the G-spot is either there, there, or there. In other words, it's amazing how a creator has made it where it's just inside where it can be found. If it's either of those areas, it's actually quite easy to find. If it's in the middle part, because there's a lump of skin there, and if you insert a finger into the vagina, you can feel that area, and sometimes it can be hard to find. By stimulating that area, I know some women have said when they do feel really relaxed and comfortable with a partner and that area is stimulated, they get really, really wet. And of course, in fact, they find it, some say it's embarrassing because I feel like I've urinated. There's just, you know, it's really, really wet. What it turns out is that the G-spot is actually the female prostate gland. The prostate gland secretes a fluid into the urethra tract and it comes out via that same tract. So it's not urine, but because it comes out of that area, they think it is. In fact, when they checked the fluid that comes from a G-spot orgasm, it turns out it's full of PSA, prostate-specific antigens, exactly the same as what a male has. In a male, we might refer to it as pre-cum, before the man ejaculates or just when he's aroused. You get that clear fluid at the end of the penis. It's actually antibacterial, antimicrobial. So normally when the penis goes into the vagina before ejaculation, this fluid is actually kind of cleaning the way. So when sperm is released, it's got a clean ground and it can go and fertilise the egg. So looking at you know, the whole reason why it's there, the funny thing is, when we look at the clitoral orgasm, which when they show from inside the vaginal area, if this is the vaginal area as a side view, and this is the uterus inside, when the sperm goes in, it's got to then swim and get up into the uterus before it can get into the eggs. When the clitoris is masturbated, this actually does that and dips down. In fact, some of the research I was doing, and I was looking at animals, and one, what's the closest to us, would be gorillas. And it turns out that with the gorilla, they'll have a relationship, like a couple, if you can call them a couple of primates, get together and she is his partner. He does allow her to have sex with other primates, as long as he doesn't masturbate her. And you think, well, why would that be? It seems they instinctively know that if she just has sex and then runs around, most of the sperm's going to fall out and she's not going to get pregnant. But what the primate does, the partner, is after he's had sex with her, he actually masturbates her clitoris, which means you get that dipping down of the uterus, so it picks up the sperm, and somehow they just know that. So he doesn't mind her sleeping around as long as she doesn't conceive with this.